gonna get there. And I'm on fire today. Ain't no water in the coma even put me off. I find a better way. Am I crazy or the wind is gonna blow me down?
Welcome to week 9 of the Bill Nees's Coaches Show. I'm your host, Chip Hare, with Coach Bill Nees. Coach, if anybody was to open up the newspaper on Saturday morning and look at the score and see 27 Butler, 25 Pickwa, they would not understand and see what that whole game was about. Indians do fall in a tough battle. Down 27-0, Coach, and boy, the second half was a completely different, it was a flip of momentum, and football is that. Yeah. It was at its best, where Pickwa puts themselves in position to win the game.
It was, and you know, I think we start off slow for whatever reason. There was a couple things. Generally speaking, I think we talked to our players about the fact that we came down and just kind of watched the first part of the game, watched the first half, and we participated in the second half. And I think that's what happened to us. Once we got a little bit of momentum, once they fumbled and we were able to pounce on that and go, then everything just kind of went our way. We were able to get our confidence level back. We were able to do a lot of things we hadn't been able to do in the first half.
Coach, I had to take the cheerleaders, escort them to the bus. I happened to come by and stop because it was pouring down rain underneath the roof, and I got to hear your conversation to the team. What a lot of people would think of, the coach went in there and fired them up. Coach, it was a conversation I heard you have with your team about playing, taking it one play at a time, cutting the penalties down, and playing the football game that you guys prepared them to play. You weren't on a soapbox.
Well, you know, pregame talks and coaches talks, they have a lifespan. They have a lifespan of maybe about 5 minutes, and then things go back, and then, you know, you've got to make something happen on the field. And I think what we were doing is, we came out of the locker room, and I think everybody's like, okay, we're going to give this a shot. But until we were able to actually get that first turnover or get something going, that's kind of what got the wheels turning a little bit. You got a little bit of movement. And then, you know, something good happened to us, and then we piled that on, something good happened, and you can just see the difference. Vandalia Butler guys were starting to lose it a little bit. We were starting to gain it a little bit, and then it just continued to roll from there. But, you know, momentum's an interesting situation, especially with high school kids, that, you can talk, yell, not yell, inspire, not inspire, whatever it is, but there still has to be some action that gets people truly involved in jumping on that bandwagon and start moving.
On the side, it was cold and rainy, but for about an hour, no one recognized the temperature or how wet it was outside on the Pickwa side in the second half, because you could just feel that energy, mm-hmm. You could feel the heat. And it was very contagious.
It was big, and we ended up the third quarter ended, the fourth quarter came, and the whole team came up together. Usually it's just the offense or defense. Everybody came in together. We had people talking, people were coming vocal, people had a confidence level going, and it was just one of those things where we were almost positive we were going to win the football game.
As things turn out, things don't turn for us as we had hoped. We fall in a tough one. Here we are, week 8. Now we've got Tipp City right on the brink. Talk a little bit about what those conversations are with your team about the week in and week out, because it's very frustrating as you want to just maybe talk a little bit more about the Butler game and what did or what did not happen. But we get turned around, you got a good team in Tipp City waiting for us.
Yeah, that's life in our end of the woods, so to speak, that almost every week we've got a lot of teams that we play that have the same amount of people we have, the same amount of caliber people we have. One thing that we talk about quite a bit is the fact that when you get to week 7, 8, 9, and 10, it's not necessarily how much talent you have, it's how much talent is going on the field. Who's got some people hurt, who's got some people not hurt, and specifically what positions. There's a couple of positions that I think we're deep at. There's a couple of positions that we'd actually have to change some and create some people. So I think that the biggest thing we want to talk about with our players is every week, it's going to be a big game. And this is why it's important that when you start at the beginning of the year, you're consistent. And you say, the only thing that's important is this week. The only thing that's important is next week, the week you're in. And now, when it really matters, it's pretty easy to preach.
Week 9, The last two are at home, Alexander Stadium. It's nice to know that we're going to be in the confines of our own facility and our stadium. Tipp City comes in, a very good football team, a team that has given us, we've had some real battles with them in the last couple of years. What can we expect to see? Everyone knows their wing tee, but what can we expect to see? Anything different from Tipp City, or is this the usual Tipp City team that comes in that they're very tempo-oriented?
I think all of the above. I think defensively, they play a very sound defense. There's a couple things that they do that are different than other people, and people try to take advantage of it, and they know that's what people are going to do. So they have a plan. They're ready. I think offensively, they're very creative. I think they're always going to have some new thing, something new that you're going to have to be able to withstand. A lot of times it happens early in the game, so I think we're going to have to deal with that. Their special teams are solid. They got a kicker that's kicked the ball out of the end zone or into the end zone, 33 out of 38 kickoffs, inside the 10, 33 out of 38, and then 12 after that. But moral of the story is he's an excellent kicker. He's got some leg that he can get down there. So they have a lot of the good things going for him.
We talk about a game that's still a relevant game. It's relevant for the division. It's relevant for playoffs. You have two games remaining, and this is the part of the season where you've got to not just physically stay yourself afloat, but mentally too.
Definitely. And I think our players are resilient. I like the way they operate. I think they operate, after the game's over with, they're not happy. And everybody looks to say, one of the things we like to ask our players is, think about, everybody should think in their mind after you lose a football game, is there one play that you personally could have made a difference that we would have won the game? And I like to do it to myself and say, is there one call that if I would have done differently, I think we could have. And if you do that, you're going to improve. You're going to get better rather than just say, well, hey, it all boiled down to one play. And you can't do that. That's way too
Many plays.
It's a total oversimplification of a very complicated situation on a Friday night when you have 22 high school football players running around and coaches and all this thing's happening, and oversimplified by saying one thing. Nobody can capitalize it like that. So if we're doing that and we're continuing to learn and we're staying healthy, we're going to be fine.
Well, I got a sense I'm talking with the guys on Saturday and again in the hallways today at school. You talk about that mojo and that chemistry at the beginning of the year. You sense that still. There is not I don't see dejection. I don't see anybody feeling sorry for themselves. I hear people talking about Tipp City today.
That's what we should be doing. We should be talking about Tipp City. Once you get back to school on Monday, it's time to roll. You've had all the weekend to deal with whatever you had to deal with. It's nice for the coaches because we get to start watching the film and we can get our mind quickly off of it. You can bury yourself in the film room for quite a bit of time and come out 72 hours later and everything's rosy and it's Monday morning. So I don't know the players get a chance to do that though.
Well, we've talked about our leadership all year in terms of our seniors and the chemistry and how that wells. Today, our senior features are Brennan Toopes and Grant Toopes, two of the three Toopes combinations. Both of those guys certainly have made a huge impact on our program, both on and off the field. Talk a little bit about how both of those guys, have you seen them, not just this year, but through their years and their time here at Piqua?
They've both been outstanding players for us. They've been to all of our camps. They do everything in the weight room. They've been outstanding role models, throughout the whole process of this deal. And for them to both be enjoying probably their best season, I really like it when you can say, my best season was my senior year. You feel bad for those kids to say, wow, I was good. My best season was my junior year, and then I kind of tailed off. And these guys are getting better, better, better. Brennan is the guy that calls all of our defenses, and he's got to look over and in this no-huddle world and everything. He's got to get it, throw it down, get everybody lined up.
You have
up
to have good football intellect to do that.
And he does a nice job of that. Grant is just a tower, out there at his defensive end spot. He's getting off the ball as well as we've had anybody get off the ball at that defensive end spot, and has a great amount of quarterback pressures, tackles, et cetera, et cetera. So we couldn't be more pleased with what the Toopses are doing right now.
Both of them have made huge plays at big points of games where we've gotten wins this year, and the guys really do follow their lead.
They do, and that's a great group that we have with all those guys, and they're just two more of the components of it.
Well, we're certainly going to look forward to watching them play here on Friday night as the Pickwa Indians host Tipp City on senior night. Coach, we certainly wish you well as we continue to move forward.
Thank you.
Guys, we will come back for part two and meet our Toopes guys, Grant and Brennan. Stay right there. Welcome to the second half of the Bill Nees's Coaches Show. I'm your host, Chip Hare, and with us now is our senior feature portion of it. I'm going to have these guys introduce themselves, their names, and their positions.
Brennan Toopes, senior defense tackle and tight end.
Grant Toopes, I'm a defensive end.
Gentlemen, this has been a very good season thus far at 5-3, coming off of a tough loss at Butler. Brennan, how do you respond to that? I mean, you know, game where you're down 27-0 and then to put yourself back in a position to win a game. What's going through your mind at halftime when you're down 27-0 and to make that kind of a comeback? What are some of the things that you're thinking about at that point?
You just kind of want to start over, and everyone wants to calm down. You want to get everyone on the same page, and you want to just go over defensive plays, offensive plays, get everyone together, and then come out and just try act like a 0-0 and just come out firing, just like the first half.
To be in that position where you see they're continuing to fumble and continue to fumble, and you're seeing yourself back, and do you see your confidence growing as a group? What's some of the feelings you're seeing on the sideline? What's that energy and that emotion like?
It starts building a lot of momentum up, and it just makes us keep rolling and rolling and rolling, and getting better and better each play.
Obviously, the Indians fall short. We have another one to go. We've got Tipp City, and then of course Troy. But it's Tipp City now. How do you focus now back into that game?
Obviously, the loss was negative, but we could obviously tell, even if we are down, we can come back. But yeah, you want to move on 1 week at a time. I mean, we win this, we win the next game, we'll have a good shot to make the playoffs like we wanted to do.
You talk about, I hear a lot of the seniors that come on, they talk about playoffs. Is that in your mind? I mean, how much do you think about that at this point? I mean, I'm sure it's in your mind all every year, but now as we get closer to the end of the season, it really is becoming a reality.
You always want to focus on it, but you want to focus on the games that you're in right now so you can make it in there. So, like, I'm just focused on Tipp City right now. That's my main focus this week, is Tipp City.
Great answer, and I, Coach, would be pleased with you. That is the right answer, and speaking of Tipp City, it will be Tipp City and Pickwa here at Alexander Stadium, with it being senior night. And senior night is a big night because we honor you guys, and it's hard to believe you guys. I swear it was just 5 weeks ago we were in D.C. together, and here we are. Yeah. And we're getting ready for senior night for football. What's this for you, senior, being a senior and playing for Pickle? What's it meant for you, Brennan?
It's crazy. The last 4 years have been some of the best, and it's sad it's coming to an end, but you know, you just want to make the most of it.
What are some of your goals as you get past, you know, when you graduate? What are some of the things you're thinking about being a year from now?
I was planning on either going to Cincinnati and majoring in engineering or attending Miami School of Business.
Oh, great. Wonderful. Grant, what about yourself? Here we are, senior night. We're honoring our seniors. We got a large group, a good group, a core group of seniors. Guys have good chemistry with one another.
Great chemistry.
Yeah. I'm sure for you to see that, you know, this brotherhood that you've bonded, mm-hmm. is pretty special with them.
Yeah, it's really special. I've been friends with all these guys for like my whole life. So just being able to play with them the last year, you can't beat it.
I would be behooved me if I did not. Shame on me if I do not. If Owen was here, you'd have a 3-0. You get that question a lot, I know. Are you brothers? What's the story there? But for you guys, you guys have received a lot of positive attention this year. What's it been like for you to know that the three of you here, you get to finish your senior year together here the last couple of years at home?
It's great. I mean, you can't anywhere else better, honestly. All three of us together, been playing for since we were little. It's great to play together.
Brennan, what's it been like for you, the triple T's together?
It's fun. I mean, we're always joking around together, just like in film. We were joking around. No, it is great, honestly, because like we said before the season, we know what each other are going to do. It just helps that we've been playing together for so long, and yeah.
You can see that there is true chemistry, and you know, Grant, for you, you move on. Here will be a year from now. you're going to be very successful. But what are some of the things you're thinking about for your future?
I'm undecided right now in college, but I hope some football opportunities open up for me, because that would be, I mean, if we go to the next step for college football, that'd be good. That'd be good. That'd be cool. But I'm just undecided right now. But I want to go to college for business. So, yeah.
We certainly know that you guys, both of you, will be very successful. And we certainly wish you guys the best. But before we get to then, we've got to get to Tipp City. And we certainly wish you guys the best against Tipp City. And we thank you for joining us. Just a reminder again, it will be senior night here at Alexander Stadium when the Pickle Indians will host the Tipp City Red Devils in a GWOC North Division game. Very important for many, many reasons. Kickoff here at 7 o'clock. The replay will be here on the Indian Nation Station on Monday at 5:30, again with the Bill Nees's Coach Show to follow. So for the seniors, I am Chip Hare. We will see you next week here on the Bill Nees's Coach Show.